Hello everyone, it's Frances with Your Book of Memories. I've got a quick Mother's Day gift here, and I want to share with you some of my students' work. So let's look. These projects are great for craft fairs, which I'm going to be attending one this Mother's Day weekend, Saturday and Sunday in Central California, so I'm super excited. I used Mintay papers, Graceful, the new 2021 paper pack. I've got some little watercolor botanicals, I just handmade those. And then I added some stash flowers and fussy cut around me handwriting notes right there. And then I got a little beautiful ribbon. Now this beautiful girl on the front is fantastic. And we also have this wonderful iridescent paper. And I cannot get over this. This is a simple project I actually created a while ago, but it's my notepad holder and post-it note holder class. And it is a little bit of an old one, but it's still a really good one. Right here on the front and side cover, you have this main little flap here. You hold some notes, and this is actually interchangeable. So when you're finished with the notes, you can take it out. And then you're totally good to go and you can just stick your new piece in. And I bought these notepads from Target, beautiful fit. And then right here, a Dollar Tree pen, okay? And you could mix and match whatever you think goes good with the collection. And then I made a little post-it note box with a magnetic closure. How cute is that? You can keep your post-it notes in there, and best of all, you can actually take a note and stick it in here. And whatever loose notes you have laying around, you could shove in this awesome pocket. Okay, it's open here and all the way here. And it's just closed down right there, and I would stick my notes in there. I'll leave the tutorial link down in the description for you. And now I want to take some time to share with you some of my students' work. They are absolutely excellent. So as you know, I'm an artist that I actually teach classes online. We have so much fun. Look at how amazing. Now Roberta, she did an excellent job with her beginner's mini album version 2. As you can see, she used the Graceful Mintay paper pack. Look how she decorated. This is absolutely fantastic. And Roberta also made a beautiful and simple mini trifold folio with this gorgeous paper. Look at the little bike and the little couch. Oh my goodness, just I love the way she decorated this. And my friend Stephanie, she created a fantastic simple mini album version 4. She has her photos in them. Look at that. What beautiful pictures inside there and an excellent album. And we have my student Eleni. She's just fantastic. Look how she decorated this again, beginner's mini album. Wow. Look at the punches she used. Look how many different customizations you can do. And oh my goodness, she even made a Merry Christmas memory box. Check this out. Isn't that just brilliant? Tracy went ahead and used this beautiful, oh my gosh, this paper is just fantastic. Look, it's so summery. She made the clutch folio. She's got some charms hanging on the side. And oh my gosh, the way she decorated the inside is just marvelous. And she even made a baby book. Oh my goodness. This is a baby book version of the clutch folio. And look how different they look. But it's the same inner working design. And let's see what Ellen did. She created the animal style folio using super cute puppy paper. Look at all the amazing pictures you could put in this book with you snuggling with your little fur guys. Oh my goodness. And also she made an 8x10 zoo themed. Oh my gosh, look how pretty. And Tanya, look how she decked out the baby mini album design. I love her doodle lines on the front. We have super adorable little eggs of a little dinosaur. She's got the buttons and the lace. Look at the inside of this book. These are things you can do. My students are having a blast and they are just so good at it. What a fantastic job, Tanya. And oh my goodness, check out this one. She used my friend Adibil, if I'm saying her name right. Oh my gosh, the fun folio design. And look at all the fun, amazing elements and beautiful, beautiful family photographs going in there. I am just amazed. She also did the slim folio, and look at her, she decked it out. This is incredible. What fantastic projects. And oh my goodness, Susan, she did a zoo theme for the animal style folio. Check out how she decorated the front cover. Oh my goodness, look at her tags inside there. I just love it. And she even made a clutch folio. Check out that handle she put on. Isn't it amazing all the different ways that you can customize these? Wow, and look at the inside. It's just brilliant. And let's check out Sarah Johnson's book. Look how she decorated the front of this trifold album. Oh my goodness, that's an old tutorial I made, but look at all the razzle dazzle on that. That looks amazing, and also beautiful, beautiful waterfall there. Along with that, she made the Memory Box album as well, and look how many fun sequins, and we got a little stuffed animal dude right there. Oh my gosh, and look at all the amazing elements that you can make, and look what she did with it. We have a beautiful spread out picture of all the different little elements that come out. What a fantastic project. Everyone who decided to share their pictures with us today, I just want to say a big thank you. Most of all, for being a friend to me. And you guys are excellent students, and it's my honor to be your instructor, but most of all, your friend. And oh my gosh, you guys are amazing artists. Thank you so much for sharing this with everyone today. I don't want this to be the last time I do this. And again, for those of you who are new, check out the tutorial trailer if you're wondering what some of these classes look like and what we'll be walking through. I'll be playing a tutorial trailer after this book, and it's truly been my honor and my pleasure most of all to share this with you. Thank you again, all my friends. I love you guys all so very much, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello everyone, it's Frances from Your Book of Memories. Welcome to the Post-it Note and the Notepad Holder tutorial featuring this awesome Cartabella Country Kitchen collection. For our covers, we're going to need our paper trimmer and our worn out blade with our chipboard, okay? So with the grain, I wrote correct, that way we know. And I'm going to make a half inch wide strip along the long edge of my 8.5 by 11. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and press it down. Yes, yes, yes. We wanna make sure we line up the beginning of that pencil line right here in the center of our gusset of our paper trimmer, where our blade goes. Now we're going to rotate this with the 8 3/8 inch side along the top. And we're gonna score at 2 inches. So I'm gonna go bottom left corner, and it's gonna line directly on top, okay? But I'm just pretending I'm sticking the whole thing down. Two pieces cut at 2 1/4 by 3.